you know, team. He loved being a monitor and putting his explorers. I was one of his explorers. And
now, what does that mean? I know a lot of people say they were explorers. What the heck does that mean?
It's a term Bob used. Bob mm-hmm. loved to make up terms, and he had what he calls his focus levels that he would set up through his research. And
he would have loved L. Ron Hubbard, you know.
Oh, yeah, oh, really? Well, anyway, Bob, when I met him, I was in the right place at the right time because he was just doing his research and just starting some programs around the country. Did not have, you know, the buildings in place now that he has where people come to him. So anyway, it was the early days, and I, through his research with me and the others, he got information. He got that our guides gave us. My guidance would take me through all these energy systems and put a light bar, you know, in.
No, I want to sort of stop you here because you used the term guides.
Yes.
Are we talking about entities either disincarnate or did they take on some form like a hologram or something like that?
Everybody, Virato, everyone who would get into the check unit and do, you know, this, have a session, would meet some type of an entity that was non, you know, what you would call it, it's not of this earth.
I mean, would it be like
had different forms.
Yeah, a dream state is like a dream state or what?
I mean, actually, it is. It's an altered state. You know, we're in the beta now, and then the tapes would take you into the alpha, and maybe even lower into different states, and then that's where things would start happening, and you'd really would not be aware of your body. But focused in was mind awakened, body asleep, and at that level, you had you just weren't aware of your body, and then things started happening. You'd go places, and my energy, the guides came as light at first. Some of the guides would come to people with a cape on, maybe not to frighten them, and then as they got to know the person they're working with, they would show themselves, and you know, the guides came in all different forms, but mine came in light, that sort of light. And then they became like beings. First, just
now,
specks of light.
I should tell our readers that your second book that you wrote a couple of years ago, which is called Soul Journeys, My Guided Tours Through the Afterlife. Now, during our interview, our little chat yesterday, you mentioned Radiant Lady.
Yes.
As a name of the lady. Now, did you come across her as a guide during your first trips at the Monroe Institute, or did it come later?
Really, no, it was when I was younger. I was about 20 or so, and let's see, maybe I was closer, a little further up, 25. I'd already gone to college, but one night, she appeared in my room. It was dark, and I was tired. I'd been working with young people. That was my job, which was wonderful, but it was late. I got home and just went to bed, very tired, and just closed my eyes, started to go down, and all of a sudden I felt someone was watching me. I opened my eyes, and the room was dark, and here was this incredible form, beautiful form of a lady in this blue flowing gown, standing there looking at me. And, you know, I didn't know anything about any of this, and I was sort of shocked, and I didn't even sleep much that night because it really took me aback. But she came then
Hold that thought, Rosie, because I don't want to break it up.
Yes.
Let's take a commercial break and we get back, and you're going to tell us all about the Radiant Lady. My guest today is Rosie McKnight, the author of several very powerful books, the last of them, Soul Journeys, My Guided Tours Through the Afterlife. My name is Virato, and you're listening to The Enlightening World of Virato Live on 880 The Revolution. And we're back with Rosalind A. McKnight. She's the author of two connected books. One is called Cosmic Journeys, My Out-of-Body Experiences with Robert Monroe. And the other book, the newer one, is called Soul Journeys, My Guided Tours Through the Afterlife. And when we left before the break, we were talking about the Radiant Lady who you said you contacted well before you ever came in touch with Bob Monroe.
Oh, absolutely.
When you were around 25 or so. So I'm not going to give away your age, but we're talking like 50 years ago.
Okay.
Something, 50 years ago that you met this radiant lady. So tell us more about her.
Well, she came, I found out she came back then when it was time to write this book.
Mm-hmm.
And she said that actually the beings on the other side had written the book and they were going to drop it down to me. And that sounded good. But anyway,
that sounded good.
But she came back and said that she had just come to check on me, just to let me know, you know, that, you know, she didn't say anything. And I, all these years, just sort of put her in the back of my mind.
Now, this is after, this is now during the period of your being with Robert Monroe, correct?
Well, no, I wrote the second book after, in fact, both books I wrote after Bob.
Okay.
Took his last out-of-body journey.
Gotcha.
But she, what happened is she came and said that she was going to take me on some very special journeys to show me what it's like before we come into this earth, and then how we set. There's a committee, it's kind of a Earth Life committee that we all have before we come in that help us to decide exactly what we're going to choose for this lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
And so she, I met that committee of people, and she was like in charge of it. And it was really fascinating, and she took me to different places in the afterlife. I say she took me, but they would send imprints, life imprints to me, just these images that I would get in a state, sitting at my computer. And then these images would come to me, and I would get into them and then begin to have these experiences. And I went with her through, she, you know, talked about having seven levels of dimensions with some levels that she sort of took me through, actually. And I met then my guide that had worked with Bob. He called him Osso. I visited with
What did he call
him?
What did he call them?
Ah, so. See, because my guide said that he didn't want a name, that it didn't want to be pulled down into the earth plane by people, you know, latching onto him and whatever. But Bob couldn't handle that. He had to have a name. So, so he had a little bit of a Chinese or accent when he first came through. And also Bob was like, so that's it, Osso. So when I met Osso on the other side, he said, oh, there's quite a sense of humor there. And they always thought it was, you know, really funny that Bob just called him Osso. And he didn't mind. But I'll tell you what, Virato, it was such an incredible experience while I was writing the book. Because of all the energies of Radiant Lady and the other beings that I met, that I just was taken into a higher level of I mean, I felt so good. And people who read the book feel that. I recently just read my book again, so I remember what it was about. And I was so impressed because of the energy. There is energy in the Soul Journeys book that people say really changed their lives, and that it's the best book they've ever read because it has a really neat flow to it. And I just read it last week, and I couldn't put it down, my own book.
Would you say that the book then is a channeled work?
I don't know. You know, Bob never liked the term channeled, and I'm sitting at my computer, but I go into a state. It's sort of like the hemisync state, you know, I go down into a level, and then I don't even remember I'm there. I'm going, they're sending these sort of imprints from my life to me to get me started. And the next thing I know, I'm somewhere